Hi friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Techie Bees. Friends, today I have come up with the unboxing and review of the 50 inches View Cinema TV. This model is different from the 55 and 43 inches variants as it comes with VA panel while the other two have IPS panels. So now let's get started with the unboxing. The 50 inches View Cinema TV comes securely packed in this branded box. Inside the box, you get two stylish metallic pieces of tabletop stand that have been given a rose gold finish. Apart from this, you get two AAA batteries, a Bluetooth cum IR remote, an audio video cable, a power cord and a wall mount. On the remote, there are direct buttons to Netflix, YouTube, Amazon Prime and Google Play. It also has a Google Assistant button on it. The build quality of the remote is decent. It looks pretty attractive in the dual tone black and gold finish. On the bottom, you get a View branding on it. The build quality of the TV is pretty good. The back is constructed out of black high-grade ABS plastic. On the front, the bezels are ultra slim on three sides, while on the lower side, a slim soundbar has been fused in. While designing the soundbar, utmost care has been taken not to make the TV look old-fashioned, as some others in the market. The soundbar is not at all broad. It is pretty slim with a golden lining on the top as well as on its mid portion. On the left bottom, there is a View logo in gold, while a Dolby Audio logo has been stuck on the right side. When placed on its rose gold metallic tabletop stylish stand, the TV looks pretty stylish as well as modern and premium. This TV comes with 3 HDMI ports and 2 USB ports. Both HDMI ARC and CEC are there on this TV. You'll be able to connect your HDMI compatible home theater also with it. Apart from this, there is an AV port, a headphone jack, an Ethernet port and an antenna port. DLNA connectivity is also present on this TV. To make this TV ultra slim, this time the company has undertaken 100% robotic assembly, due to which the brightness on all parts of the screen is almost uniform. The brightness of this TV is 500 nits. This is the first TV in the budget category that has been graced with this high brightness. This breakthrough in brightness is attributed to View's own Pixelium glass technology, which increases the light reflection by up to 40% without increasing your electricity bill. As I told earlier in one of my videos related to TV purchasing guide, high brightness is seen only in the higher range TVs of bigger brands. Companies do lay stake to the claim of gracing their budget TVs with HDR10 and Dolby Vision. But these features are more of an eyewash, as very high brightness is needed to exploit the full potential of Dolby Vision and HDR10 in a TV. This TV supports Dolby Vision, HDR10 and HLG videos. And as the brightness is pretty high, all videos in these three categories play beautifully with much clarity. This TV comes with D-LED backlighting and VA panel. Despite having a VA panel, the viewing angle of this TV are decent. Though there is some color distortion when viewed from sides, it is limited to a bare minimum. The performance of all 4K, Full HD and HD videos is very good. Its color reproduction is natural and accurate. All different shades of any particular color can be easily differentiated. The clarity in dark and bright scenes is amazing. Black is adequately deep and it turns out to be uniform on the entire screen. Digital noise reduction works beautifully on this TV. Now coming to HD and SD channels. HD channels look very good on this TV and the performance of SD channels too is satisfactory. The most important thing is that all format videos, whether they be TS, WebM or MP4, all play smoothly on it. 4K videos at 60 frames per second also play beautifully on this TV without displaying any lag. This TV gives you umpteen options for picture and sound settings. There is also a cricket mode which gives you the liberty to watch cricket with minimum blur without losing sight of the ball. For your varied requirements, it also has a game mode and PC mode. This TV comes with VOD upscaler and there is also an option in the settings to switch it on. The picture upscaling capability of this TV is very good. Even low resolution videos turn up pretty good. The refresh rate of this TV, like any other budget TV, is 60Hz. During normal television viewing, you will not see any motion blur, but definitely during very fast action scenes, you cannot escape the blur. Now coming to its audio, this TV is graced with 40 watts multi-directional front-firing speakers and tweeters. It comes with Dolby decoders and surround sound. Including game and stadium modes, it has 7 modes. With a dedicated soundbar, the audio of this TV is certainly very good. There is an amazing clarity in the dialogue delivery, for which there is an option in the settings to enhance it further. It will not be an exaggeration to say that this TV is an amalgamation of very good picture quality as well as audio. The overall experience that you get on this TV is wonderful. It comes with Bluetooth 5, whose connectivity with other Bluetooth devices is pretty fast. You can connect your headphone, keyboard or gaming pad with it wirelessly. Its voice command feature is highly responsive that understands your commands effortlessly. There is also a built-in Chromecast in this TV which supports Android, iPhone, MacBook and Windows. Casting is pretty smooth on this TV without any lag. However, during MiraCast, videos did display considerable lag. This is an official Android TV that comes with Android Pie operating system and the company has also promised OTA updates for this TV. So the next Android 10 update will definitely come to it. You can play Netflix and YouTube on this TV in 4K resolution. This TV comes with a single band Wi-Fi, but surprisingly, I did not face any issue while connecting it to any network. In fact, it was able to catch long distance networks too. The 1.5 GB RAM and 8 GB ROM is definitely low. But despite this fact, all applications played smoothly on it in 1080p even when connected to a Jio SIM. However, you need to keep in mind that to play a 4K video, a broadband connection with high internet speed is definitely required, otherwise the TV will hang. Low-end games can be played smoothly on it, but for playing high-end games, you will require a gaming console. For the first time, this series gets a dedicated help center where you will get a solution to all your TV related queries. Now coming to the views after sale services, it can be termed as the best in budget category as the company itself provides doorstep services rather than allocating the services to a third party. Apart from this, you can also get in touch over phone with the company's technical support team for providing solution to any of your TV related problem. In my opinion, at this price, this TV is a steal as its picture quality and audio are comparable to higher range TVs of Sony and Samsung. It certainly has some cons like low RAM and ROM and single band Wi-Fi, but these cons seem too small in front of its excellent performance. However, we do hope that in future we will bring a TV in the budget category that would constitute a complete package with higher refresh rate and more RAM and ROM. In my upcoming video, I'll bring to you a side-by-side comparison of the VA Panel, View Cinema and the View Premium Android TVs. So friend, hope this video proved helpful to you. Meet you in my next video. Till then, take care and bye-bye.